Good evening. The last class has started the ray optics. And we have discussed about the results. Among the important result is number of images. I already given an example. When you go to any gallery or any fitting room or even in the barber shop or any beauty parlor, if you are seeing plenty of images of yourself can be visible. So how many images are found? This is an important thing. In this case, I want to discuss elaborately in which way, who is that. The two things we want to discuss now. One is called the number of images found. That is the general formula n is equal to 360 by theta. That is called n, number of images, 360 by theta. So suppose two plane mirrors are inclined at an angle 60 degree, what happened? So this is a plane mirror 1, this is a plane mirror 2. If they are inclined at a 60 degree, if a person standing in between these two, then simply you have to find first of all 360 by 60. The answer is 6. That means the number becomes 6. 6 is odd number or even number. So it is a even number, very good. If it is an even number, we have to subtract it 1. Therefore, 6 minus 1, 5 images are formed. So that is a focus. So when you focus all the point, the first point itself is an object, so that remaining only a image. Therefore, the formula modified as 360 by theta minus 1 for even number. So suppose two plane mirrors are kept at 90 degree, what happened? That is 360 by 90, that is 4, again 3 images are formed. But suppose 40 degree, what happened? 360 divided by 40, so that become 9. So what is 9? 9 is an odd number or even number? It is an odd number. If it is an odd number, we have to keep as it is. So how many images are formed? Only 9 images. So when you go through everything, first you have to find 360 by theta, where theta is the angle of inclination given in the problem. Simply substitute 360 by theta. If 360 by theta value comes in the even number, minus 1 is the answer. If 360 by theta is an odd number, put as it is. That is a thing you have to remember. So another thing I want to discuss now, what is the deviation? It is given in the slide, but I want to discuss with you. Deviation, what is called deviation? So if you are deviate your subject, if I am teaching physics, immediately I switch over my subject to chemistry or mathematics, immediately you can say, oh, you are deviating the subject, sir. Like that you can. Deviate means there is a slight change in the path. It is called a deviation. So far, deviation is possible only for refraction of light. But unfortunately, here we are citing reflection of light. Even reflection of light, deviation is there. Is it possible? That is a new concept. So the deviation is only possible for refraction. Apart from that, deviation is included now for reflection is there. How? Suppose I take a mirror. This is a mirror. Any line drawn 90 degree is called a normal, you know. If light enters, so because of that mirror only it gets reflected. We discussed in the previous class. But kindly imagine yourself. If this mirror is absent, what happened? This reaction goes there. So because of that mirror only, it comes here. Without a mirror, it goes as straight line. Why this deviation is happening? This deviation is happening only because of the mirror is there. Therefore, this is the deviation now. This is the deviation. Actually, it goes straight line. But unfortunately, it goes in straight. It deviates its path. So it is called deviation. So deviation is also possible for reflection of light is concerned. So we already discussed this value is called angle of incidence. This value is called angle of reflection. So what is the total angle now? I plus R plus D. I plus R plus D is equal to 180 degree. Am I correct? Why it is 180 degree? Because it's straight line. What is the angle for straight line? 180 degree. That's angle I plus angle R plus D is equal to 180 degree. What is your answer now? I want to find out deviated angle. 180 minus this goes I plus R. So this is a formula for actually deviation. D is equal to 180 minus I plus R is the formula. In some book they are having in terms of I or in terms of R. Why? We know for a perfect reflection I is always equal to R. If I is equal to R means I plus I 2I. Therefore the formula can be modified as 180 minus 2I. This is a very important formula. What is I? I is the total angle. This is the thing we have to understand. Here the angle of incident. So what is the formula for deviation? 180 minus 2y. Or 180 minus 2r also correct. Because 180 minus 2r also we can put. There are three formula. We have to keep your mind. What is the angle of deviation? Is 180 minus I plus r or 180 minus 2i or 180 minus 2r. So these are all the things I have given in the table. Number of images formed, n is equal to 360 by theta, theta angle of inclination of two mirrors. If n is equal to 360 by theta for odd number, odd n, so what is the answer? 9 comes. For example, I have given 40 degree, what is the n? N value is 9. If it is an n is an odd, therefore n 360 by theta. If n is an even, that means n minus 1 number of images are formed. Therefore 360 by theta minus. So the slide also I have given, the deviation of a ray produced by a plane mirror is pi by pi minus 2i. Why I put pi? Pi is nothing but 180 degree. This is the radian. Be careful. So I have derived the slide pi minus 2i or 180 minus 2i or 180 minus 2r. I is the angle of incident. Everything I have seen in the. Now spherical mirror. So here also I want to discuss with you. If the reflecting surface is part of a sphere, take a sphere. This is a sphere. If the sphere cut into two portions, two halves, halves, H-A-L-V-E-S. If the portion two halves, I get one portion is like that, another portion is like that. There are two portions. If the reflecting surface is inner, we call this concave. If I take the reflecting surface outer, convex. So not like your ordinary plane mirror, one type, whereas these spherical mirror are two types. One is called concave, another is called convex. So how can you identify whether it is concave or convex? So kindly go through the reflecting surface. In all diagram, the shadow portion is called the quartered portion. So other side is called the reflecting surface. Here the reflecting surface is inner. Here the reflecting surface is outer. Then there are two types. One is called concave and convex. So I will take concave. Let it be. Because reflecting surface is inner. This mirror has its own center. The center is called center of curvature. The center of the sphere is called center of curvature. And also the center of the mirror will call as pole. There is a lot of difference between the center of curvature and the center of pole. The center of pole is nothing but the mirror center. Where spherical center is called or sphere center is called center of curvature. The line joining of pole and center of curvature is called principal axis. So the spelling is very important. What is the spelling here? We have to use principal axis. P-R-I-N-C-I-P-A-L. Very important formula spelling. It is not P-R-I-N-C-I-P-L-E. So as far as the physics is concerned, you are simply put principal. It is not principal. it is a principal axis. Because it is very important axis, so it is called principal axis. What is called a principal axis? The line joining of center of curvature and the pole. Line, L-I-N-E, not L-I-O-N, L-I-N-E. The line joining of pole and center of curvature is called principal axis. So here what happens? If light ray enters, gets reflected. Here also light enters, gets reflected. So kindly go through the diagram. All the reflector light rays are meet at a single point. That the single point on the principal axis is called principal focus. So here F is called principal focus. All the reflected light ray are meet at a single point. Whatever the plenty, even infinite number of lines after reflection has to pass through a single point. That single point should be on the principal axis. That single point is called principal focus. Is a principal axis that is called principal focus. The distance between the pole and the center of curvature is called radius of curvature. The distance between the pole and the principal focus is called focal length. So small f I put because of focal length, that is called radius of curvature. PC is equal to capital R, PF is equal to small f, where small f is called focal length. So these are the things we have to understand. What is the first type of problem was in Japan and all medically entrance examination, even you went to the NEET syllabus. That is the advantage of this syllabus, more than 4 problems comes in this area. That is important because these are all medically important for us, so that in all medical entrance examination they are concentrating more than 4 or 5 problems in this area. The first problem, the relation between these two, that is radius of curvature is always equal to twice the focal length. Keep your mind, R is always equal to 2F, or F is equal to R by 2, whatever may be the thing. So these are all the things you have to understand as far as the concave mirror is concerned. But is in convex what happened? So convex, that is a reverse. That means the reflecting surface is outer. Here also having principal axis. So it is all a center of curvature, light ray centers. What happened? It gets reflected because reflection in the outer side. So we extend it. So these reflected rays meet here. Therefore, kindly observe, as far as convex is concerned, all the light rays are appear to come from a single point. Here all the light rays are appear to meet at a single point. So the previous class we have discussed that if light rays are meet at a single point, it called as converging ray. Hence the concave mirror otherwise called as converging mirror. Similarly, convex mirror, here light rays are appear to come from a single point, diverges. Therefore convex mirror otherwise called as diverging mirror. So this was given in this slides, can you go through? There is a thing we have discussed, everything. F R is equal to 2F, from which F is equal to right. Image formation by concave mirror. There is a thing I have to given the three simplicity, that is called a shortcut technique I have given in the slide. What is the image formation? So image formation may be asked 20 types of question in the medical entrance examination. The image formation by the mirror, there are 20 type of questions or 20 type of problem we have to keep our mind. So how can you keep your mind? For that only I have given the three important note. What are they? Number one is, all the light rays are incident parallel to the principal axis. After reflection, go through a focus. So how can you keep your mind? Any line or any ray incident parallel to the principal axis, after reflection, go through focus only. So keep your mind. So if it is a parallel line, after reflection, go through focus. Reverse, if the light rays are incident through focus, after reflection, go parallel. So keep your mind. Parallel lines goes through F, if it goes through F parallel. So if light rays passes through the center of curvature, what happens? After reflection, retrace its path. What is the meaning of retrace? When what is the path which enters, that is the same path it relieved. So be careful. Whenever the 3 points, the first and the third, you have to keep your mind. When light incident parallel to the principal axis, go through F. If light incident through F, go parallel. There are 2 points. The third one, if light ray incident through center of curvature, retrace its path. So how can you find out this? So that I can explain with an example. So I have given a chart also, keep your mind. Very important, there are 20 type of problems. So how can the stem of the question will be there? If the O means object, place beyond C. If the O means object, if the object is placed beyond the C, this is a first question. If the object is placed beyond the C, what are the type of question may be asked here? Where the image is formed? Where the image formed? Okay. That is the thing. If the object is placed beyond the C, where the image is formed, or where image is formed? That image is real image or virtual image? That is the second type of question they may ask. Since whether it is real or virtual, where the image is formed, real or virtual, enlarge or diminish. So the image we formed is whether it is bigger than the object or smaller than object. You have to keep, this is a stem of question. If the object is placed beyond the sea, even stem of the question, this type of question may be, sub question may be asked. For these questions, there are 4 choices are given. That is different. Where the image is formed, that a formed image is real or virtual, enlarge or diminish. Another one is erect or inverted. Erect or inverted. So these are the question asked for a single question. So in which way you have to answer it? So I have given the 3 important points. But take a concave mirror. This is a concave mirror. This is pole. This is center of curvature. This is the focus. What happened? When you go through the question, where the image is formed, object is placed beyond the sea. So you have to keep object here. So how can you apply it? The ray incidence. I already told you that any ray incident parallel to the principal axis go through F only. So it reflected ray. Another ray can pass through C alone. All others are filled. If it passes through C, what happens? If the ray passes through C after retrace its path. Here also there are 2 reflected rays, 1 and 2. Here it meets here. So in plane mirror it is not meet. So here it meets at the place. That is a place where image is formed. Very easily to find out. So as soon as go through the diagram, you can immediately answer the previous question. Where the image is formed? Image is formed between F and C. That is the answer. Whether it is real or virtual, I already told in the previous class itself, what are the conditions for real image? If the image is formed in front of the mirror, the image is always real. So it is also formed in front of the mirror, therefore the image is real image. When it is real, automatically inverted. That is also given in the condition. What about the size of the image? The size of the image is smaller than object. Therefore, the image is diminished one. So the image is diminished one. So like that, each and every point, there are 4 questions. There are 5 categories. So kindly do it at home. The remaining thing, the object is placed at the C where the image is formed. If the object is placed between F and C. Okay, there is a 2 things, the 3, another thing, there are 5 questions. So one more thing I want to discuss now. If the object is placed between P and F, what happens? Object is placed between P and F. It is important for you. So for that case, so these are the one to discuss now. So this is a mirror. This is a board. Focus, contract curvature. If the object is placed between P and D, what happened? It's always reflected through F only. Another ray has passed through C, it also reflected in the same direction. But it is not possible to meet the two reflected right on the in front of the mirror. But we can extend the ray. The extent of the ray may they meet behind the mirror. So here image is formed behind the mirror. So where the image is formed behind the mirror. Since it is behind, real or virtual? Virtual. Size, L naught. Erect or inverted? Since it is virtual, it is a erect image. So kindly keep your mind. That is an important thing. Since the image is erect, so this is very similar to that of your plane mirror. What is the important difference between the plane mirror and this concave mirror? Object is placed between P and D. From the diagram, what do you infer? Anybody says? What is the difference here? So this is very similar to that of plane mirror. Here also image formed behind the mirror. In plane mirror also formed behind the mirror. There also virtual image. Here also virtual image. One important difference is here we are getting enlarged image. That is advantage. The size of the image is very, very big. When you are using ordinary plane mirror, the same size we are seeing. Here we are getting very high, very long or very more bigger size of the image. That is advantage. So last but here or 2 years back, one question asked in Japan, which mirror is used for shaving purpose? We have to use shaving. So to shave our or to remove our hair, we have to shave. So in order to shave, which mirror we have to see our face? So usually all the students are answering only the plane mirror. But it's wrong. Plane mirror, the image is same size. If you are shaving by using a concave mirror, what is the size of the image? Enlarged. Therefore, we can identify where the hair growth is more. Immediately we can identify that place, spot out, by using a bigger image. So, what is your correct answer? Which mirror is used for saving purpose? Your answer must be concave mirror, not plane mirror. So, keep your mind. Because only one thing, we are getting enlarged image. What is the advantage of enlarged image? Even a smaller size of the body can be visible very easily. So, we can able to remove the particular hair immediately. So, which mirror is used for saving purpose? Your answer must be concave mirror. So, these are all the things in the slide. So, this is a chart I have given. So, do it at home by geometry method. So, it is called geometrical optics. So, I have to draw a diagram and verify the following. The first one is, if the object is placed at infinity, where the image is formed. If the object is placed at infinity means the parallel lines are coming from long source. The example I have given a diagram. So in this, kindly go through. If the light rays are coming from very long distance, after reflection, they meet at a single point at focus. So since it is a long distance, the image is real image, inverted image, very, very diminished. Otherwise, some book they are putting as point image. Beyond C, just now I have given the diagram, the image may be formed between F and C. The image is real, inverted, diminished. Up to C, kindly do it at home by geometrical method or by doing drawing. Up to C, the image is also formed at C, real image, inverted, same size. Between F and C, the image may be formed beyond C, real, inverted and magnified. At F, if the object is placed at F, the reflected rays go parallel. The parallel lines never meet. That may meet at infinity. They may be meet at infinity. Even if you extend the ray on other side, never meet. So, even in front of the mirror, it goes we can get the answer, the image may be at infinity. Since it is infinite, real, inverted, highly magnified, we think that it is highly magnified. Between F and P, just now we have seen, behind the mirror, since the image is formed behind the mirror, the image is virtual image. Since it is virtual, they are erect and magnified. That is advantage of here. Since concave mirror produce magnified image, they may be used in the same purpose. May you form a convex mirror, just now we have seen. If the object is placed here, so we are getting an image always formed between P and F. There is a point image, always erect. Always erect means always virtual image and it diminish between P and F for all positional object. So kindly one thing you have to keep your mind, for convex mirror is concerned, the image is formed between P and F only. The image is virtual. Since it is virtual, erect image. Be careful for all positional object. And the image is always diminished and enlarged image we cannot find out by convex mirror is concerned. So these are all the things we have to keep your mind for image formation by the mirror. So many questions may be asked because the mirror formula and all other things we have to understand. Okay. Now we have to see what is a problem oriented as far as the concave mirror or convex mirror is concerned. So in all these cases, you have to keep your mind about the sign convention. So without knowing a sign convention, we cannot be able to find out. So that the formula is called mirror formula or distance formula. The relation between focal length and object distance plus image distance, 1 by F and 1 by E. So here PO, object distance from the pole is called U. Image distance from the pole is called V. I already told you that the distance between the focus and the pole is called F. If 3 is the case, that is the formula related, 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. Very important formula. Then what are the sign convention we have to keep your mind? The sign convention, be careful. I take a concave mirror, so it is a pole, focus, contraparent. So first point for sign convention, every distance should be measured from pole only. What is the meaning of that? Any distance we have to measure, we have to keep the zero of the scale at the pole only. So you should not argue yourself. If anything PF 5 cm means FP also 5 cm maybe. But here we have to follow the one direction, that means any distance or every distance should be measured from pole only. So any letter starts from pole. So that I already discussed that distance of the object from the pole, U. Distance of image from the pole, V. Distance of the focus from the pole, F. Distance of center of curvature from the pole, radius of curvature. So you see all the distance. These all the distance are starting point is P. What is called P? P is called pole. So every distance should be measured from the pole only. So you have to keep your scale at the zero only at the pole. That is the thing you should not argue. So you should not argue PO is equal to U, OP also equal to U, maybe. But here we have to analyze yourself and you can understand yourself. The second point. If the distance is measured along the direction of incident ray, keep your mind. In any way, you have to keep your mind. You need not write anything. You have to keep your mind. That is important thing from the slide. If distance is measured along the direction of incident ray, from left to right, as far as the blackboard is concerned, put to positive. You need not worry about it. The value is given is 5 cm. Put to plus 5. If the distance is measured along the direction of incident ray, or sometimes the distance is measured against the direction of incident ray, put a negative. Put a negative. VC, PF, like that. In this direction. If it is on right to left, we have to put a negative. Keep your mind. for solving problem. If you are confusing here, no problem, arrive the result. That is important thing. The result is entirely different value. Therefore, the first point, every distance should be measured from pole. The second point, if the distance is measured along the direction of incident ray, right, left to right, put to positive. If the distance is measured against the incident ray, that means right to left, put to negative. If the height is measured perpendicularly upward direction from the principal axis, the height is measured up. If the upward direction, put to positive. If the height is measured downward direction from the principal axis, put to negative. If the height is measured perpendicularly upward direction, put to positive. If the height is measured perpendicularly downward direction, put to negative. This positive and negative you have to keep your mind. Another thing, for important thing, only for focal length, it's not confused for other. For focal length alone, if concave mirror is there, focal length is negative. For concave, the word concave, whether it is mirror or lens, if it is a concave word will be there, the focal length is always negative. For convex, if you see the word in the problem, convex, focal length is, we have to take as positive. So be careful. Then what are they? Why I am telling so many times, without knowing the sign convention, you cannot solve even a single problem. What are they? Number one, the distance is measured from pole only. If the distance is measured along the direction of incident ray, put to positive. If the distance is measured against the incident ray, put to negative. Am I correct? Why it is positive? Why it is negative? So you can keep your mind. If the height is measured perpendicularly upward direction, so from principal axis in the upward direction, put to positive. If the height is measured perpendicularly downward direction, put to negative. For concave, this is exclusively for focal length only, or not for other. If focal length for concave mirror is concerned, negative. For convex, whether it is mirror or lens, positive. If you are thorough on mirror, that may be useful for refraction. That is, for lens, it is very useful. So these are all the things I have given. 1 by u plus 1 by v is equal to 1 by f. Or simplifies, u become vf by v minus f. Or if you want to find out v, uf by u minus f. Or f is equal to uv by u plus v. Because this is the case. There is a 1 by f is equal to uv mcf u plus v. 1 by f is equal to u plus v by uv. Or f is equal to uv by u plus v. Or in terms of u means, if v and f are given, vf by v minus f. If u and f are given, v is called uf minus u minus. So these are the thing after. What is magnification? So I already told you that the size. The size of the image. How much time the size of the object. That is called magnification. So the magnification, general formula, m is equal to, what is magnification? The size of object divided by size of image is called magnification. Size of object by size of image is called magnification. Otherwise, the formula is called minus v by u. Don't forget it. As far as the mirror is concerned, the formula is minus v by u. I have given minus v by u. Why you put negative? That is for real image. So if your answer for magnification is negative, we can come to the conclusion that the image is real. For real image only, we are getting the answer for magnification negative. For virtual image, it will become positive. So other formula, f is also equal to f minus v by f or f by f minus v. Don't forget it. So what are the given parameters in the problem? If v and f are given, substitute f minus v by f, or F by F minus U. Substitute this, we can able to find out. These are the formulae for. So sign convention. So I already discussed with you. The distance are measured from pole. The distance is measured along the direction of incident ray positive against the direction negative. The height is measured upward from the principal axis positive, downward direction negative, focal length for concave negative, focal length for convex is positive. Magnification M is positive for virtual image and for negative it is for real image. This already we discussed. What are the defects in the getting image? Number one is called spherical aberration. What is a spherical aberration? The parallel beam of light after reflection from the concave mirror is focused at a single point. That is called a principal focus. If the beam is narrow or aperture of the mirror is small, how it is possible? All the rays which are parallel to the principal axis after reflection go through the focus. When? If the rays are very close rays, and also aperture is also very small. If the wide beam, two rays are coming, the two rays are, the distance between the two rays are very large, that is wide distance, and also the aperture is more, then the image is fuzzy. F-U-Z-Z-Y. What is called fuzzy? This means confused image or blended image we are saying. So we cannot distinguish the image. So it goes two or three shaked image. That is called fuzzy. Somebody take photograph by using camera. If you are taking photograph, if you are shake your hand, what happens? Your image is fuzzy. So that the camera should be fixed on the stand. That is better. If you are take the photograph, even in the cell phone nowadays, a wide megabytes, that is a very advanced version of camera with a palsy lens and other thing, very advanced the system introduced now in the cell phone itself. So the image taken from the cell phone, advanced camera was introduced so that we can get a image, very clear image in the cell phone. Apart from that, the camera. Once it was a very old camera, we know that the camera should be keep the camera under the stomach. What happened? We have to press it. Then when the slide will be, shutter will be open and quickly. So if you press it, what happened? Automatically the camera will move. The camera will move mean when you printed the photography without a head or without a leg, we are seeing the image. It is a very awkward image will be there. So the shaky or fuzzy. So spherical aberration can be taken care of either by using a small aperture mirror or parabolic mirror. So when you see the automobile headlights in motorcycle and cars, we are getting a parabolic mirror we are taking, the curved surface. Have you seen? The parabolic mirror is best to avoid fuzzy image. So we can see the perfect image, we have to use parabolic mirror and also the aperture. It passes through the ray, the filtering ray should be very small thing or very close ray, the thing. Then only the spherical aberration may be rectified or may be reduced by using parabolic mirror. That is a thing, one thing I will remember. What is spherical aberration? The spherical aberration, the thing is considered. When a ray of light is incident on the boundary between two transparent media, a part of it passes into the second medium with a change in direction, refraction, at a plane surface. So that is actually, we have finished the reflection of light. The reflection of light, spherical aberration is one new thing, and I have given everything. So what is the thing, uses of the mirrors, uses of mirror, plane mirror, every day we are using plane mirror. Concave mirror, where it is used. The concave mirror is used for saving purpose and another use. Have you seen a concave mirror anywhere? When you go to dentist, yes. So there is a cavity in our teeth. The dentist cannot go into your mouth and see where the cavity is. So what happened? He take a small mirror, just like your long thread or any rod. At the end of the rod, there is a mirror will be there. So you open your mouth and keep the mirror on the teeth. So from the reflection, we can come to the conclusion where the cavity is there, and he is doing this one. Apo, in dentist, it is very much useful. The concave mirror is useful by the dentist, and also ENT specialist. When you go to ENT, ear, nose and throat, that there is a light when is there. On the back side of the light, there is a concave surface mirror. What do you keep your mind? Wherever any light is focused, we have to use concave mirror. Any we want to spread out the light, we have to use convex mirror. So where the convex mirror is used? Where the convex mirror? Sometimes we are using a rear view mirror, isn't it? While you go to motorcycle or car, anything follows you. You cannot turn your head and see where the object is. So we have to see, or we have to observe from the mirror only. That mirror is called rear view mirror. So from the mirror only, what is the object coming behind you can be identified. So which mirror is used? Somebody wrongly write most of the examination, and also you are itself confused. Which mirror is used for rear view mirror in motorcycle and car? Kindly make note of this. The mirror used in the car and motorcycle is convex mirror, not concave mirror. The convex mirror only we are using. What is the advantage of convex mirror? The convex mirror gives the object very close to you, the image. When you see the image, it is very close to. Actually, it comes far away. So we can identify, or we can do any mistake, we can escape from the mistake by seeing the distance. When you see through the convex mirror, it appears very close. So nowadays, the mirror, in the mirror itself, the line or engraved, that means object in the or image in the mirror appears very close. Actually, it comes there. So actual distance, when you actually turn your head and see the object is far away from you. When it is seen through the mirror, it appears to very close to you, so that we can make adjustment by yourself. If it is on concave mirror, object actually comes very close to you. When it touches, immediately it touches you. When you view through the mirror, automatically it shows very far away from you. So if you are committing any mistake, definitely accident will happen. Therefore, the rear view mirror is convex mirror. So the rear view mirror, convex mirror. Concave, dentist and ENT specialist, saving purpose in all other things, for focus. In the headlight also, we are using only concave mirror that can be focused light we can give. Only other question is asked, which mirror is used in the table lamp? Table lamp. So we are using table lamp for our study purpose. So which mirror is used there? You are simply confused, isn't it? I already told you that the mirror which is spread the light is called convex. So here also, all the light should be focused the entire part of the book. Therefore, the mirror used is called convex mirror. So which mirror is used in the street light? Somebody confuses you. Well, the street light is there. Even in the street light, the mirror is there. Any shining part is called mirror in motorcycle or car. Kindly go through the headlights. There is a curvature will be there. The curvature is called concave mirror. So in order to focus the ray, we have to use concave mirror. But in street light, the light has to spread out. In order to spreading out, the convex mirror is used. In the street light, convex mirrors are used. These are the some advantages or uses of mirrors. Okay. So this is the concluding part. The one other thing, you are confusing yourself, which mirror is used for? Rear view mirror and shaving mirror. These are the two things. In most of the medical entrance examination, which mirror is used for shaving purpose, the question is asked. You are simply write a plain mirror. The plain mirror is wrong. So the correct answer is, in order to get a saving purpose, we have to use concave mirror. What is the reason? What is the difference between a concave mirror and a plane mirror? Both are same. But one difference is, in concave mirror, we are getting enlarged image. Whereas, in the plane mirror, the same size. So, in order to shave or in order to remove the hair from our face or anything, if it is viewed through concave mirror, we are getting enlarged image. So, it is easy to remove it. And also, another condition where, in motorcycle and the car, the rear view mirror is only convex mirror, not concave mirror. Somebody write concave, that is wrong. The rear view mirror is only convex mirror, because in the mirror itself some lines are written. What are they? Object or image in the mirror appears closer than actually it comes. So that there is a distance we have to clarify. The distance for driving is very important. That timing is very, very important. That mirror is called convex mirror. And also, in automobile headlights, the mirror is concave mirror. In the street light and the table lamp, we are using only convex mirror. Dentist and ENT specialist, all the doctors are using only concave mirror to see the cavity and also to see the eardrum, everything. These are all the medically oriented questions that may be repeated in our examination. You have to keep your mind. These are all the uses of the mirror. That is a thing you have to keep your mind. That is fuzzy. When it is fuzzy, if spherical aberration is there, the image is fuzzy. What is the purpose of spherical aberration? If two rays are far away, after reflection, the image, blended image or fuzzy image, we are seeing. So, in the camera and other thing, you have to keep the aperture. The aperture is very, very important. So that I have told you that the lens is very, very important in the camera is concerned. So that Colsi lens and other advanced lenses, megapites, everything you are having. So you are purchasing a camera, by 8 GB or 8 MB, like that we are saying 16. If you go like that, the quality of the lens is more, that is a thing. If you are shake your hand, what happened? Definitely the image will be fuzzy. So old lens age, we are having only camera, that camera should be shutter. Even before the camera, we have to open the shutter by close. So some screen will be there. We have to remove the screen and immediately close. Then only the image. So many problems was there. Not the shutter opening by click time. That was open. The camera we have to use under the stomach. If you press the button, what happened? The camera will shake. The camera will shake, what about the image also? Shake. Most of the images are negative, comes positive, without a head or without a leg, we are seeing when the photo is printed. So nowadays, very easy. Nowadays, even in the cell phone itself, we are having a wonderful cameras. Very nice camera we are having in the cell phone itself, very clarity will be there. So these are the thing for reflection of light is concerned. This completes your complete reflection of light. The reflection of light, we have seen reflection at a plane surface as well as under the reflection at a spherical surface. In order to solve formula or problem, we have to keep one important formula, 1 by F is equal to 1 by U plus 1 by V. What are the sign convention? We have to keep the sign convention. Without understanding the sign convention, you cannot solve even a single problem. What are they? Every distance should be measured from pole only. Very good. If the distance is measured along the direction of incident ray, put positive. If the direction is measured away from the incident ray, put negative. If the height is measured perpendicular upward direction, put positive. Downward direction, put negative. Exclusively for focal length, for concave, whether it is lens or mirror, for concave. If you go through the problem, if any word you are seeing concave, definitely put focal length only negative. This is for focal length alone. For convex, when you see the word convex, if it is a mirror or lens, put positive. That is important. Then magnification. Size of the image by size of the object, the magnification is negative. If your answer is negative, we can boldly suggest that the image is real image. For real image, magnification is negative. For virtual image, magnification is positive. Don't worry, take it from me. Any question they ask, immediately we can substitute it, we can answer it. We'll solve the problem, then we can identify what are the importance of the sign convention. Be careful. That is a thing. Without a sign convention, we cannot solve the problem. So that I am repeatedly tell. When you go through the problem, then we can make use of that. So these are all for reflection. Reflection at a plane surface, mirror, reflection at a spherical surface, concave and convex mirror. So tomorrow we will see what is the refraction of light. So it is a reflection is over and the refraction of light, then we will come to the conclusion. Okay, thank you.